Is there a name for a show that's passable across the board, except for one particular attribute? That's what I'd call the four-episode 1988 OVA Vampire Princess Miyu. It's based on a manga that had just started that year, with both manga and anime created and directed by the same husband and wife team, imagine that, Toshiki Hirano, director of Magic Knight Ray Earth, amongst others, and Narumi Kakanouchi. So we're already off to an unusual start with this one. Vampire Princess Miyu is a supernatural horror series that focuses on two protagonists, a Himiko, an adult woman, who is a sort of spiritualist detective whose cases often cross paths with the titular Miyu, a young vampire girl. Miyu, accompanied by a mysterious cloaked protector named Larva, seeks out and destroys evil Shinma, which are mischievous spirits a bit like, say, traditional Japanese oni or yokai. Okay, you may be thinking. This sounds like a typical demon hunting show. We'll get to why it's different in a minute, but let's start by talking about the animation. That is admittedly kind of my thing, you know. So, typical for anime, especially an atmospheric, psychological horror story, there are a lot of static shots with no movement in Miyu. Fortunately, those moments are chosen well to let us really focus on the imagery being shown to us. When characters do move, they do so cleanly, with plenty of budget to represent that movement. Nothing feels either weirdly over-animated or cheaply under-animated, especially given the average budget of a late 80s OVA. Remember, Akira was just hitting at this point. Characters remain on model throughout, and the show avoids out-of-place anime visual cliches like face faults or nosebleeds. Wouldn't feel right. Similarly, the pacing matches the tone of the show very well. It's a slow series, giving the audience time to reflect on eerie visual imagery and each line of dialogue. Okay, so no more beating around the bush. It is in the writing where Vampire Princess Miyu shines. Not talking about individual lines of dialogue here, but the nature of each episode's story and its implications for its characters impress me. This series is full of tragedy and heartbreak and well-intentioned decisions that don't work out as well as intended. Also, interestingly, Miyu sets itself squarely in the modern and completely normal world. So many horror stories just soak in gloom, where everyone seems to live in a perpetual haunted twilight. Not in Miyu, where bright, cheerful colors abound in much of each episode. Side characters live happy, average lives to all appearances. This actually makes the inevitable dark encounters with Shinma all the more unsettling for the contrast, so good job there. Unfortunately, this depth may not seem obvious in the first episode or two, as Miyu and Himiko establish this simple, straightforward, antagonistic relationship in what initially appears to be a straightforward demon hunting series. Himiko sees Miyu as this evil predator who just feeds on humanity and probably is in league with the Shinma somehow, while Miyu sees Himiko as a hot-headed mortal who just interferes with Miyu's Shinma hunting job. Seems very straightforward. Miyu herself presents an interesting enigma to the viewer, though, right from the start. She seems completely comfortable in her role, calmly seeking out Shinma and banishing them to the dark, as she calls it. When humans obstruct her, she usually works around them with no stronger reaction than a wry smile. She appears to lack any angst or melancholy about her lot in life. Although when questioned about her little vocation or her relationship with her protector, Larva, she becomes strangely evasive. It's a neat twist on the standard "I'm fated to hunt demons, woe is me" formula so common in anime. Fortunately, the final two episodes do what I never expected, and no spoilers here. They actually delve deeper into Miyu's backstory and explain her attitude. The staff don't just tell a couple of unconnected horror stories here, typical of a lot of these sorts of OVA, and the final episode works as a surprisingly satisfying ending for an ongoing horror franchise, right? Those tend to just kind of go on. Quick side note on the dialogue and voice acting. I deliberately listened to half of this OVA in English and half in Japanese. The main performers do perfectly respectable jobs with their characters, while a lot of the side characters in both languages are really, really cheesy. Just be aware. It's kind of remarkable. Overall, though, Miyu gives supernatural horror fans precisely that. Lots of the supernatural and horrific storylines about relatable people making ultimately poor choices. While its various elements like animation, sound, and voice work don't quite elevate it to classic status outside of its genre, it's one of those anime series that executes on its concept admirably well. This is quality.